Hey Siri, what is the definition of knife crime?
Knife crime means criminal offences committed using a knife as a weapon.
Begin. Please insert a pound. Beep.
Now, please choose your scene.
Beep, beep, beep.
You have chosen kitchen scene.
Proceed.
Oh, so you're back then?
Yeah. What's to do with you?
Well, it kind of is everything to do with me, seeing as I'm your wife.
Shut up already.
You know what? I'm fed up with you. You come in here, night after night, with whatever filth you're with, while I'm stuck here, looking after your kids.
Mum, don't bring me into this.
Shut up! Shut your mouth. But no, I'm just your wife. All right.
Knives have always been a casual thing in my day-to-day life. My mates play with them like little kids play with crayons. Like they're toys, like they're not harmful. They're everywhere and I guess I just wanted to fit in.
You now have a choice. A, take the knife, or B, leave the knife. You chose to take the knife. Proceed.
Oh, what's happened then?
My mum and dad have been fighting again. But this time my mum, she's pulled the knife out on my dad. So I've brought it with me so she doesn't like stab him or anything.
Good job,
you
got that knife.
Oh,
come on then.
You got a knife? Go on, get it out then.
You now have another option. A, retaliate, or B, walk away. You chose to walk away.
You know what, I can't be arsed.
Okay, Uh-oh, you just got stabbed. Game over. Rewind. Oi.
Good job you've got that knife then.
Oi, wanky.
Get out then.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
You now have the same choice and you choose to retaliate. Go on then.
All right, you want to see this person? Oh, you just got stabbed. And just like 39,818 people, they also decided to pick up a knife. Game over. Game over.
Game over.
Carrying a knife will always get you killed.
I present the case of the perpetrator versus the victim. Today, we will find if the perpetrator is guilty of murder by means of a knife, and it is up to you, the jury, to reach the verdict. Can I call the perpetrator to the stand? Raise your right hand. Do you promise that the testimony you shall give in the case before this court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
You detail to the court your version of events from the night of the victim's death.
We'd just left the club, and I called a taxi. I saw him. He was talking to my girlfriend, and he got a bit too close, and he started touching her. I'd never done anything like this before, but I lost control. I saw red.
You've carried a knife for years, haven't you?
I've carried it for as long as I can remember. I didn't know it was illegal.
You meant to kill the victim, didn't you?
I just wanted him to back off. I didn't mean to hurt anybody. I carried the knife because it put me in control.
Stand down. Can I call the witness to the stand? Raise your right hand. Do you promise that the testimony you shall give in the case before this court shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Can you detail to the court your version of events from the night of the victim's death?
We left the club around, what, maybe midnight? Perpetrator rang for a taxi and that's when I saw victim. We're old friends. We went to high school together. We were just catching up like friends do. And that's when the perpetrator pulled out the knife and ran towards the victim.
Has the perpetrator ever been violent before?
No. Well, I mean, he's been aggressive, but he's never done anything like this.
Have you ever tried to stop the perpetrator from carrying the knife?
He didn't listen to anyone. He felt safe when he had it.
Stand down. Have the jury reached a verdict?
Guilty!
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 The jury find that in the case of the perpetrator versus the victim, the perpetrator is guilty of murder by means of a knife, and you are sentenced to life in prison.
The maximum penalty for carrying a knife is 4 years in prison. You can be convicted if you're caught carrying a knife more than once. If you choose to carry a knife, whether it is real or an imitation, you will be arrested and prosecuted. The law is clear. If you choose to carry a knife, you put your future in danger.
Danger! If you don't take it with you, it won't be used.
You really think I wanted this to happen? My son locked up in jail? No. Don't look at me like that. Don't put the blame on me. It's not our fault.
You alright?
Where's he off to?
Out with some friends, I think.
What friends?
I don't know, I didn't ask him.
Well, next time you should. We haven't met one of his friends, he could be going out with anyone.
Look, he's a good lad after all.
If you say so.
Seen that girl he's been going out with?
Yeah, why?
Don't know, she just seems a bit odd. Not really someone I'd put him with.
Maybe she was just shy. Hey! What are you doing? It's 2 o'clock in the morning.
I heard shouting outside again. They sounded so aggressive, it just scared me. I found a knife in his bag yesterday.
A knife? Are you joking? He knows carrying a knife can get him into serious trouble. Even jailed. We've got to talk to him.
No. If he finds out I've gone through his stuff, he'll go mad. I'll just speak to him when he gets back from that club. I'm not going to get much sleep anyway.
Look, go to sleep. We'll sort it in the morning.
The back.
Who?
Well, who do you think? The crowds of people waiting outside so they can call me a shit mother. Or blame us for our son murdering someone else's child.
They don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, do you think that'll stop them? We can't even go outside our own house without getting abuse from the public. How are we going to handle that in court?
Thank you.
seemed like yesterday I was teaching him. He was always so well behaved and engaged in class. There was never a dull moment with him. Honestly, he was a boy with a lot of dreams.
He was a lad with so much talent and potential in football. Always laughing and having fun. It was such a team sport. The club will never be the same without him. We all miss him.
He was always there for me, you know? Like, no matter what, just have that smile that just lighten up my day. He was always at mine on weekends, after school. He was part of my family, he was more like a brother to me than a friend.
He had such good intentions, aspirations, ambitions to become something. I yelled.
Oh my
God. I screamed. Oh my God. I screamed. I just cried. I didn't know what to do. Every single day, I see my son lying on that floor. Every single day. Not a single day goes by where I'm not tortured by these visions. It's been a year since my son's death. Every single day, I'm just waiting for the key to turn, for the door to open, for him to just walk in like normal. What people don't realise is, not only does that victim go in the grave, but their family and friends go in that grave too.
Knife point robberies by teens have increased by 50% in the last 5 years.
From January to November of 2018, there have been around 272 fatal stabbings and more than 1,800 reported attacks.
By March 2018, there was 21,044 disposals given by police for the possession of a knife.
There was 42,900 offences committed in the 12 months leading up to September 2018, a 31% increase from the previous year.
Please, stop the killing.
Please, no more.
Put down the knives.
They're not toys.
Sometimes in life, it's hard to tell what to do or what not to do. Whether if my friends do something that I should do that too, will that be a sin?
You're gonna sit in some poxy office with an arse of a boss telling you what to do as you count your pennies trying to make ends meet in a country that's sinking into war and despair. And at the end of the day, you go home to your little town in Nowheresville and pull your IKEA curtain shut and hide from the big bad world and pretend it's not happening. You're gonna stand up and be counted. For once, say screw it, I'm coiled up like a spring and I'm ready to burst. And tugging off ain't doing it anymore. I need violence in my life to make me feel I'm alive. I know what I'd rather do. Tottenham away, love it.
Something I want to give you, yeah? Right, it's a knife, yeah? Because you need protection, yeah? No, you've got to take it. You've got to take it, man. Come on, go on.
Hello? Where are you?
I'm at the park, why?
What are you doing at the park at this time?
It's not even that late.
Yes, it is, you need to keep safe.
We'll be right back.
1 2 3 4
5
6
7 8 9
10
11
12
13
14 15
16
17
Angel of Knives is a statue created by Alfie Bradley. It is made out of confiscated knives and represents that knives cause danger, but there's also an angel to protect us. Hopefully what you've learnt today is that the possession of carrying a knife always, always leads to danger. What you've got to remember is there's also an angel of death.
The Benkinsella Trust was set up by his family after he was stabbed 11 times. Some of his wounds were 7 inches deep. We need to realise that this isn't a joke. This is real life. More and more people are using knives in gangs and to settle arguments. But I hope you've learnt from today that we need to stop using knives, because the minute you pick up that knife, you're putting yourself in instant danger.
When we started this project, we met an amazing man called Leon. Now, Leon came from a terrible background. It was normal to have knives. He was stabbed 17 times and he died twice. But then he turned it around and he joined the St. Giles Trust. And now he goes around local communities and schools and talks about his issues. Now, if you need anyone with any support, contact the St. Giles Trust.
Gangs across the country are using deadly weapons like knives to settle arguments. People are using knives for protection. Because what they don't realise is that as soon as you pick up that knife, you're putting yourself in instant danger.